The Disciplinary Commission complaint says by allegedly groping four women in a bar one night, Curtis Hill not only allegedly committed a crime, but he also broke the rules for being a lawyer in the state of Indiana. Hill was accused, but never criminally charged, for allegedly putting his hands on four women, a state lawmaker, and three state house staffers during a party to celebrate the end of the 2018 General Assembly inside AJ's Lounge, just south of downtown. Republican lawmakers and lobbyists testified today how Hill arrived at the bar, had some drinks, appeared to show some influence of the alcohol, but they say they never saw him assault the women. When Hill took the stand, he described his role as Indiana's attorney general, essentially the lawyer representing the best interests of all Hoosiers, even when it comes to litigating on behalf of the Indiana Licensing Agency, which oversees the credentials of certain state professions. But Hill's defense is that the Disciplinary Commission has no right to seek sanctions for what might be described as offensive behavior on the AG's own private time. Earlier, a woman who worked for Hill during the last few months, he was the prosecutor in Elkhart County, testified that Hill pressured her for sex both before and after his election as attorney general and when he was sworn into office. Once the testimony wraps up this week, hearing officer Myra Selby will take the case under advisement, determine if there were any rules violations, and then determine if there should be any sanctions. We shouldn't expect that decision for some time to come. At Indiana State Supreme Court Chambers, Russ McQuaid, CBS 4 News.